Okay, in this video, I'll show you guys how to use calculus to approximate the value of square root of 8.7. Keep in mind, calculus, not calculator, right? So here is the approach. First of all, let me just show you guys a picture. And in calculus, you should always think about functions. In our situation, of course, the function should be square root of x. So let's say the graph looks like this right here. I'll put down y is equal to square root of x for you guys. Well, we don't really know square root of 8.7 too well. But what we do know is, when x is nicely equal to 9, well, the y value is just going to be nicely equal to 3, isn't it? Square root of 9 is 3. Very nice. And as we can see, when we have 8.7 into x, 8.7 is actually pretty close to 9. And in fact, maybe just right here. I had to draw it slightly, you know, with a big gap so we can see it. But technically, it's pretty close to each other, right? Ideally speaking, I should put 8.7 to this right here and calculate the y value. But I cannot do that because that's what the question is. However, this is what we can do. Instead of putting down 8.7 onto the curve right here, let's first draw a line tangent to square root of x when x is 9. So I will just draw the tangent line right here like this. So this is meant to be the tangent line. And instead of putting down 8.7 to square root, I am going to put down 8.7 to the tangent line equation. Because the tangent line equation has the form y is equal to mx plus b, and it's really easy to multiply, divide, and subtract, right? So that's the idea. Therefore, let's go ahead and find the equation of tangent line first. So what we need is two things. First of all, point, of course, x is equal to 9. And this is like my original. This is what we know, so that's the original, right? When x is 9, y is equal to square root of 9, which is just going to be 3. So the point is 9 comma 3. And that's x1, y1, right? Now, let's go ahead and find the slope. Well, for the slope, it's of course just the derivative of that. The derivative of square root of x is 1 over 2 square root of x, like this. And again, we are going to plug in at x equals 9. So we are looking at this as y prime equals 1 over 2 square root of 9. Work this out. That's, of course, 1 over 6. And this is the slope. And then we can use, of course, the good equation, the point slope form, right? Y minus y1, that's equal to m times x minus x1. And drawing everything. Okay, y minus y1, which is 3. M is 1 over 6. And then we have x minus x1, which is 9. So that's what we have, right? And now, let's do this in our head. This times that is, of course, 1 over 6x. This times that is going to be negative 3 over 2. But then I have to add the 3 on both sides. Negative 3 over 2 plus 6 over 2, we add 3 over 2. Just work that out on your own, all that good stuff. So that's pretty much the equation of the tangent line, huh? Then, what we can say is, square root of 8.7, I'll just put this down here for you guys. It's approximately equal to 1 over 6, and I'm just going to put in the x value to be 8.7 right here. And I will add 3 over 2 after that. Well, just to show you, I can do this with our calculator. Of course, we can do this by long division. Good stuff, yeah? So, we are saying square root of 8.7 is approximately equal to 1.45 plus, of course, this is 1.5. That's what, of course, we're saying square root of 8.7. This right here is approximately equal to 2.95. So, that's how you can use the tangent line approximation to help us out. Well, I will tell you guys though, this right here, on the calculator, it's going to tell you that's equal to 2.949576, and so on, so on, so on. It's irrational, of course. As you can see, our approximation is very close to the calculator's answer. Of course, we don't know square root of 8.7 too well, but we do know it's the following. Well, let me write it down right here for you guys. We know that when we have square root of 9, this right here is nicely equal to 3, right? And the reason I picked 9 is, well, of course, 9 is pretty close to 8.7. This right here is my original point. And in calculus, we have to think about functions. In our situation, we are, of course, talking about square root of x. Okay, so the x value right here is 9. And the new value is 8.7. So you can see that we have the difference in the x value. Well, if we can figure out the difference in the y value, we can get the approximation done. That's pretty much it, right? And actually, let me write this down right here for you guys. Square root of 8.7, this is the y value on the graph of square root of x. Well, this right here is going to be approximately equal to the original y value that we know, namely square root of 9, which is, of course, 3, but I need to figure out the change in the y value, right? So I'll just put down plus delta y like this. This right here means the exact change in the y value, but the problem is that we cannot compute that nicely without a calculator or whatever. But what I can show you is that, though, we can add dy for it, because dy is the approximate change, and we can just use derivative to help us figure this out very nicely. So, how can we do that, though? Well, have a look right here. For dy, first of all, of course, we are talking about y equals square root of x, as I mentioned earlier. And my original x value is 9, right? Because this is the one that we know, so that's the original. And we also have to figure out the change in the x value. Again, originally is 9, but the new is 8.7. That's what we're trying to figure out. So the difference is negative 0.3. Again, you always need to use the new value that you're trying to look at, which is 8.7, minus the original, right? Minus what you know, that's the original. So that's why dx is negative 0.3. And now we can just do the computation. To get dy, of course, you differentiate this, but you talk about differential, so you just do dy, and that's equal to, you do the derivative of this, which is 1 over 2 square root of x, but we multiply by dx. So that's pretty much it. But we have to then plug in the x value and also the dx and all that. So dy equals 1 over 2 square root of 9. And the dx is negative 0.3 that we have to multiply. Well, have a look. This right here, dy, it's equal to, this is going to be 1 over 6. And we multiply by negative 0.3. So when we do that, dy is negative 0.3 divided by 6, we will get 0.05. Just work that out. Just divide whatever you would like. So in this case, as we can see, we will be able to know that square root of 8.7 is approximately square root of 9, which is 3. And we have to add dy, which is actually negative 0.05, like this. So we are technically subtracting, right? So we are saying that square root of 8.7 is approximately equal to this and that, we get positive 2.95. And that's how to use the differential to do the approximation in this situation. For the people who are interested, just like myself, if you use a calculator, enter square root of 8.7, in fact, you are going to end up with 2.949576 and so on, so on, so on. This right here is irrational. And notice that our approximation is very close to our answer on the calculator. Very cool, isn't it? That's it.